गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर डूइंग ग्रेट। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज मोशन। इट इज अ न्यू चैप्टर एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर सिलेबस। सो इन दिस सेशन वी विल ओनली कवर द बेसिक थिंग्स, द बेसिक टर्म्स रिलेटेड टू मोशन। दैट मीन्स वी विल कवर सम ऑफ द कॉन्सेप्ट, that is a concept of distance, concept of displacement, and the various related terms, their units. All these things will be covered in this session, and in the next session we will do some question answer session and some other important topics, so that you can will understand the chapter. So at first, before starting this chapter, as this chapter is related to motion, so let me first give a clear idea what is motion. What is motion? Now the motion is when a body or when an object change its position with respect to time and its surroundings, then it is said to be in motion. Any object or any body when changes its position with respect to time and surroundings, then it is said to be in motion. So motion is change of position of an object with respect to time and surroundings. When an object or when a body changes its position with respect to time and surroundings, then it is said to be in motion. Clear? Now the question is, what is position? The question arises from the definition of motion, that what is position. Position means location of an object with respect to a particular point, that is the position. So position is location of an object with respect to a particular point, that is the location of an object. That means it is a position. Clear? Now this particular point about which the position of an object is defined, this particular point is termed as reference point or origin. Listen again, this particular point about which the position of an object or position of a body is defined, this is particular point is called reference point or origin point. So this particular point is termed as reference point or origin. Clear? This particular point is known as reference point or origin. So this is motion, definition of motion. What do you mean by the position of an object and the concept of particular point? Clear? Next, two important concepts that will be required to discuss in this chapter, that is scalar quantity and vector quantity. Scalar quantities and vector quantities. What are scalar quantities and what are vector quantities? Now, scalar quantities and vector quantities, both of them are physical quantities. Scalar quantities and vector quantities, both are physical quantities. Now the question is, what are physical quantities? Physical quantities means the quantities that we can measure, or the quantities that having value or magnitude. Those quantities are physical quantities. And if we classify physical quantities, then physical quantities are of two types. One is scalar quantity and one is vector quantity. Now what is scalar quantity? Scalar quantity is a physical quantity that can have only magnitude. Scalar quantity is a physical quantity that can have only magnitude. That means it has only value. That is your scalar quantity. Clear? For example, like mass, it is a scalar quantity. Distance, it is a scalar quantity. Mass, distance, speed, all these are your scalar quantities. Because these are physical quantities having only value or having only magnitude. So these are scalar quantities. Now talking about vector quantities, this is also a physical quantity. So what is vector quantity? Vector quantities are those quantities that have value as well as direction. Vector quantities are those physical quantities that have value as well as direction. That means vector quantities have value or magnitude plus direction. That is your vector quantity. And in case of scalar quantity, it has only magnitude. It has only magnitude. That means value. It has no direction. That is the difference. So, example of vector quantities like for example, weight. It is a vector quantity. Next, displacement. It is a vector quantity. Velocity. This is a vector quantity. So, all these are your vector quantities. That means all these quantities having value as well as direction. That's why they are vector quantities. So, this is scalar quantity and vector quantities. Clear? Next, we will discuss separately displacement, velocity, speed, all these things, distance, all these things will be separately we will discuss. Clear? So, first make a heading that is distance, concept of distance. What is distance? Distance. Now, you all know that distance is a scalar quantity because it has only magnitude or value. It has no direction. That means it is a scalar quantity. Now, what is distance? Distance means the actual length of the path covered by a body. Distance means the actual length of path covered by the body. That is your distance. That means the total length of path the body travels. That is the distance. So, it is total length of path traveled by a body. By a body or you can say by an object. That is the distance. And it is also scalar quantity because it has only magnitude. It has only value. It has no direction. That's why it is a scalar quantity. What is the unit of distance? Its unit is meter per second in SI system. In SI system, its unit is meter per second. And in CGS system, its unit is centimeter per second. That is the unit of distance. Clear? Suppose you are moving like this. This is the origin point, O point. This is the origin point. This is the A. If you have moved, this is the 5 meter. You are moving in the direction from O to A. Then again, you are moving from A to B. You are moving from A to B. This way. Suppose this is the 10 meter. Again, you have moved from B to C. This way. This direction, in this direction, suppose the distance is 8 meter. Again, you have moved from C to D. This way. This way. This direction is suppose 20 meter. 20 meter. This distance is 20 meter from C to D. Now the question is, what is the total distance covered by you? The question is, what is the total distance covered by you? So you simply, to find distance, you will simply just add this length of journey, because this is the final, this is the initial position point O, this is the final position point D. So what you will do, just add these numericals. That is, add these numbers, because this is the length of journey from O to A, this is from A to B, this is from B to C, and this is from C to D. So to find the total distance, you will have to add these small distances to get the total distance. Clear? So total distance covered by you will be this OA plus this is the AB, so length of AB plus this is BC plus this is CD. So just add. Now OA is 5 meter, AB is 10 meter, BC is 8 meter and CD is 20 meter. So just add 20 tens are 30, 38s are 38, 38 and 5s are 43. So 43 meter. So total distance is 43 meter. That means distance is actually the length of path covered by you or the length of path traveled by you. That is the distance. Clear? And it is a scalar quantity. Unit is meter per second in SI format, and in CGS format it is centimeter per second. That's it. क्लियर. सो दिस इज द डिस्टेंस कॉन्सेप्ट. नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट फिजिकल क्वांटिटी मेक अ हेडिंग डिस्प्लेसमेंट. नेक्स्ट फिजिकल क्वांटिटी इज योर डिस्प्लेसमेंट. डिस्प्लेसमेंट डिस्प्लेसमेंट. नाउ डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज इट इज अ वेक्टर क्वांटिटी. डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज अ वेक्टर क्वांटिटी बिकॉज इट हैज वैल्यू मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डिरेक्शन. नाउ व्हाट इज डिस्प्लेसमेंट. डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज द डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज द चेंज ऑफ पोजिशन ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट. द चेंज ऑफ पोजिशन ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट व्हेन इट मूव्स फ्रॉम अ गिवन पोजिशन टू अनदर पोजिशन. व्हेन अ बॉडी और व्हेन अ ऑब्जेक्ट मूव्स फ्रॉम अ गिवन पोजिशन टू अनदर पोजिशन डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज जस्ट द चेंज ऑफ पोजिशन ऑफ दैट ऑब्जेक्ट. दैट इज द डिस्प्लेसमेंट. सो इट इज बेसिकली चेंज ऑफ पोजिशन ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट व्हेन इट मूव्स फ्रॉम अ गिवन पोजिशन फ्रॉम अ गिवन पोजिशन टू अनदर पोजिशन. दैट इज द डिस्प्लेसमेंट. क्लियर. एंड इट इज एक्चुअली दिस डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज एक्चुअली द शॉर्टेस्ट डिस्टेंस. इट इज एक्चुअली डिस्प्लेसमेंट मीन्स इट इज एक्चुअली द लेंथ ऑफ शॉर्टेस्ट डिस्टेंस विथ डिरेक्शन. लेंथ ऑफ शॉर्टेस्ट डिस्टेंस विथ डिरेक्शन दैट इज द डिस्प्लेसमेंट. सो जस्ट राइट इन ब्रैकेट डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज लेंथ ऑफ शॉर्टेस्ट डिस्टेंस विथ डिरेक्शन. Length of shortest distance with direction. That is, displacement is the shortest distance with direction. Now, this is very important. Distance with direction. Distance with direction means displacement. Distance with direction means displacement. If you omit this direction word, then it is only distance. But if you add direction word with distance, that means displacement. Clear? So, displacement is length of shortest distance with direction. What is the unit of displacement? Its unit is same as that of distance. Unit of distance and unit of displacement both are same. Clear? Unit of distance and displacement both are same. So displacement is in SI method it is meter and in CGS method it is centimeter. In SI mode, unit of distance is meter, and in CGS mode, unit of displacement, unit of distance is centimeter. And the same goes for displacement. Unit of displacement in SI mode it is meter, and in CGS mode it is centimeter. Clear? And also it is a vector quantity. Clear? Now suppose you have start from this point O and moves along a straight line. And moves to point A. Suppose you have started from O and moves along a straight line and move to point O, point A. Suppose the distance is 3 meter. Next, from A, you simply move towards north direction, moves to point B. Suppose the distance is 4 meter. And we have joined point O and point B. Clear? Now, suppose you starts from point O and reaches to point B via this point A. Clear? So the question is, what is the displacement here? What is the displacement of U? Now, to find the displacement, you need to find the shortest distance with direction. Now, if you there is a two way to reach point B from point O. One way is you will move from O to A and then from A to B, that is via A. And the second way is you will directly move to point B from point O. So there is a two way. So you need to calculate the value of OB, that is the distance OB. Now the question is, how can you calculate the distance OB? Just apply Pythagoras formula here, because this is the right angle triangle, this is the right angle, this is the right angle triangle. So you need to apply Pythagoras formula to find the distance OB. And you all know the Pythagoras formula, that is the hypotenuse square equal to height square plus base square. That is the Pythagoras formula. So here hypotenuse is OB सो ओ बी स्क्वायर इक्वल टू हाइट इज ओ ए, ओ ए स्क्वायर प्लस बेसिस हाइट इज बी ए, दैट इज बी ए स्क्वायर एंड बेस इज ओ ए, सो ओ ए स्क्वायर. सो जस्ट फाइंड, सो बी ए इज 4, सो 4 स्क्वायर प्लस ओ ए इज 3, दैट इज 3 स्क्वायर. सो 4 स्क्वायर इज 16 प्लस 3 स्क्वायर इज 9, दैट इज 25. देयर फोर ओ बी कम्स आउट टू बी रूट 25, दैट इज 5 × 5, दैट इज 5 मीटर. सो देयर फोर इट इज 5 मीटर. नाउ सी द क्वेश्चन इज फाइंड द डिस्प्लेसमेंट. नाउ इफ यू मूव फ्रॉम ओ टू ए देन ए टू बी, द टोटल डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज 3 + 4, दैट इज 7 मीटर. But if you move from O to B directly, the distance is 5 meter. Now the question is, which distance is short? Obviously, from O to B. So this will be your displacement. Because displacement is shortest distance with direction. And this way, that is from O to B, this distance is your shortest distance with direction. Because O to B, if you move from O to B directly, you will have to cover 5 meter, only 5 meter. But if you move from O to B via point A, then you need to cover from O to A, that is 3 meter. Plus from A to B, that is 4 meter. So total distance is 3 + 4, 7 meter. That means this is the shortest way. So that will be your displacement. Displacement is the shortest distance with direction. So OB is the 5 meter. This is the displacement. So you will write displacement equal to 5 meter. And you need to put the direction also, because displacement is vector quantity. So it has value as well as direction. So you have just wrote the value. Now you will have to write the direction also. So find the direction. So how can you find the direction? This is east direction, this is west, this is north, this is south. So this way, that means northeast, northeast direction. Clear? So displacement is 5 meter towards northeast. Clear? 5 meter towards northeast. Just remember one thing, whenever you write displacement, you have to write the numerical value, that is the magnitude, and as well as direction, because it is a vector quantity. But when you will write distance, just write the numerical, that is just write the magnitude, because distance has no direction. That was scalar quantity. Clear? That is the basic difference between distance and displacement. Clear? So displacement here is 5 meter. But if you need to calculate the distance, suppose the question comes that find distance. What is the distance? Distance means the total length of journey. Total length of journey means from O to A, that is 3 meter. From A to B, that is 4 meter. So 3 + 4, 7 meter. So distance will be your 7 meter, not 5 meter. So distance will be your OA plus OB. That is OA is your 3 meter and AB is your 4 meter. So this is AB, OA plus AB. This is 3 meter and AB, this is 4 meter. So 3 + 4 meter, that is 7 meter. So distance will be 7 meter. Clear? There is the difference between distance and displacement. Next. Next concept. What is the distance versus displacement? That is the difference. Basic difference between distance and displacement. Difference between distance and displacement. Difference between distance and displacement. What is the difference between distance and displacement? Number one is that basic concept of distance is that it is the total length of journey. Distance is the total length of journey. That is the distance. Number one. And displacement is the just change of position of an object from a point to another point. Clear? Distance is total length of journey of an object or total length of journey of an body. Clear? And displacement is the change of position of an object when it moves from initial position, from when an object moves from a position to its final position or to another position. That is, displacement is just the change of position, and distance is the total length of journey. That is the first difference. Clear? Now second difference is displacement of an object can never be greater than distance. Displacement of an object can never be greater than distance. That means distance is always greater than distance. Distance is always greater than displacement. And distance can be equal to displacement also. Distance is always greater than displacement, and distance can be equal to displacement also. Or we can say in another word, that is, displacement of an object can never be greater than distance. That means distance is always greater than displacement. And distance is also can be equal to displacement. That means we can write displacement is greater than displacement is less than distance. Displacement is less than distance. or in another word, we can say distance is greater than displacement. Also, distance can be equal to displacement also. That is the relation between distance and displacement. Clear? Now, the question is, when this distance and displacement be equal? We have said that distance is always greater than displacement. That means displacement is always less than distance. And distance and displacement both can be equal also. Now the question is, what is the condition where distance and displacement both are equal? This question can come in your question. This question can come in your exam, that write a condition or state a condition where distance and displacement both are equal. The condition is, the third point, the condition is where distance and displacement both are equal is that if a body moves along a straight line, if a body suppose moves along a straight line, that means from suppose O to A, the body moves along a straight line from O to A, that means just in one direction only, just in one direction only, then distance and displacement will be equal. Clear? Suppose the distance OA is 5 meter. Clear? In this case, distance will also be equal to 5 meter and displacement will also be equal to 5 meter towards east, because this direction is east direction. If you cross check here, this is east, west, north, south. So this is the east direction. So displacement also 5 meter towards east, distance is also 5 meter. In this case, the distance and displacement both are equal. That means the condition is, when distance and displacement both will be equal, if a body moves along a straight line, only then displacement and distance will be equal. Clear? Number four is that displacement of an object can be positive, can be negative, or can be zero also. Displacement of an object can be positive, can be negative, and can be zero also. But distance can never be negative or zero. Distance will always be positive. Distance can never be zero. It can never be negative. Distance is always positive. But in case of displacement of an object can be positive, can be negative, or can be zero. So that is the fourth difference between distance and displacement. Clear? So this is complete distance and displacement, concept of distance and displacement and their difference. Next is uniform and non-uniform motion. What is uniform motion and what is non-uniform motion? Uniform and non-uniform motion. What is uniform motion and what is non-uniform motion? Now, talking about uniform motion, what is uniform motion? If a body travels equal distances in equal interval of time, then the motion will be your uniform motion. If a body travels equal distances in equal interval of time, that motion will be termed as uniform motion. So uniform motion is a body when travels equal distances in equal intervals of time, that motion will be termed as uniform motion. Clear? That means if you plot a graph of uniform motion, this is the suppose distance and this is suppose time. So your graph will be linear. This is the graph of uniform motion, because if you just plot time in x axis and distance in y axis, and you will have a graph linearly. That is the graph of uniform motion, because it covers equal distance in equal interval of time. Both are equal. So graph will be linear. This type of graph will be linear graph. You will find linear graph in case of uniform motion. Okay. Now, in case of non-uniform motion means if a body travels unequal distances in equal interval of time. Unequal distances in equal interval of time. That is your non-uniform motion. So a body when travels unequal distances in equal interval of time. In equal interval of time. That is the non-uniform motion. That means unequal distances in equal interval of time. That is the non-uniform motion. So if you plot a graph in case of non-uniform motion, this is the time in x-axis, this is the distance in y-axis. So you will graph like this. You will have a graph like this. That will be not linear. This is a non-linear graph. Non-linear graph in case of non-uniform motion. Clear? Non-uniform motion. Non-linear graph. Next, rate of motion. Rate of motion. What is the rate of motion? Rate of motion. Rate of motion means the ratio of distance traveled by an object to the time taken. The rate of motion is the ratio. This rate of motion is just the ratio. What ratio? The ratio of distance traveled by the object to the time taken. That is the ratio of motion. So it is just the ratio. The ratio of distance. Ratio of distance traveled by the body to the time taken. That means ratio of distance and time. That is the ratio of motion. Clear? So in this session we have discussed the concept of distance, displacement, their difference, concept of scalar and vector quantity, and uniform, non-uniform motion and rate of motion. Clear? That is the end of this first session. In the next session we will discuss the topic related to this rate of motion. That means concept of speed, concept of velocity, difference of speed and velocity, all those things will be discussed in the next session. Clear? That's it. That's all for today. Thank you.